the fuel caps. The rubber seal that's in them is getting a little old, so we're replacing those. This is what it looks like in the beginning. So, their propeller ignition switch on both.
Are you listening?
Being careful around the prop, not to touch it or put our hands in the way of it. Since these aren't grounded, if we push this thing hard enough, it could start. Finished a bunch of windy landings. It's not that windy. But wait till you get about 400 feet up. Then it gets you. Yeah, the windscreen's a little buggy, so. A little bit of 10% alcohol and water mixed together. Nice fresh rag. It does the job just fine. Just had to show you guys this sunset. It is beautiful. Yes. They're firing up their. Runway 30, and if the winds are coming from 330, it's like there, and I can feel them. They're coming from right there. So a slight crosswind, but it's a headwind, so we're take off on runway 30, like we've been doing the whole time.
I intend to have you fly it. We'll get it in the air, and then it's very light on the controls. So it. So you were just flying a 172, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, it'll be so much more responsive than that. It'll just a little touch, and it'll just go. So it's got a lot of aileron, and it's got, you know, pretty good speed to it. So.
All right, so here comes the pre-oil. Okay.
All right.
Machine. It looks big and scary and difficult, but it's just smooth as butter. Gotta make it back home or to the hangar in this other beautiful machine.
Clear prop.